My name is Musa Jerjis Musaad. I am a wheat breeder now. I am an emirates situation. After 60, we have to stay far from administrative, and he will just give advice in technically and help in planning and selection, like this. I worked in wheat research department since 1st January of 1966. I have a good chance to be learn wheat breeding in Mexico, CIMET, in 1973. I spent 9 months there working with Dr. Norman Barlow, and during that time we work most of the time on the field, and there is some lecture also to help and to explain what we are doing in the field and the basic scientific basis for this activities. During that time, Dr. Barlow have to give us lecture, but he always his lecturer have to be in the field. One day he give us a lecture for 9 hours. We stay in the ditch and he stand, and when he would like to see some material, we have to run after him. And when he finds somebody made mistake in selection in crossing, and we have to put our name in our crosses, he have to hide the mistake. Nobody realize who is it, do this mistake, and ask the trainee, what's the problem here? And after that, he will ask us to leave and pull the plant and cut the spike, because he don't like to contaminate the crossing material, because it was a off type. The plant was taller than the normal plots. This is why he recognized it, and he have to do to correct it. And he's always taking care for everything, even if he would like it. If we are from Arabic country and we would like to take photos of him, and if he have a glass of Coke, he have to put it far, not to show in the picture, not to hurt the people, to say maybe he's drinking something or something. He was very serious, and we learn from him. He's always saying, talk with plant. And this is the best way to learn about wheat, is to talk with plant. When you visit the field, every day you will find something different. The plant can tell you if it's sick, if it is healthy, if it needs water, you can understand it. But if you visit the field often, you cannot realize the growth stages, you cannot realize the difference in growth happening to the plants. This training course, when we start, when we arrive there in February, we took a bus from Mexico City to Ciudad de Obregón. We spend about 3 days, and we spend about 2 nights or 3 nights in the road, Guadalajara, Los Mochis. And when we arrive to Ciudad de Obregón, they give us every trainee a bottle of a solution of spores of rusts, and we have to inject the F2 plants, and we spend 15 days and we have to kneel down and to inject the plants by the spores. Also, this is just to let us to be adapted to work hard in the field. If you are not adapted to work harder in the field, you cannot learn about wheat breeding and the other activities. After we finish this, when we start crossing, they explain for us how to make the crosses, how to mesculate. And after we have to mesculate, to make the mesculation and pollination, but Dr. Barlow himself have to select the parent for female and male, because he have to plan it. After we finish the normal crossing, they give us chance to everybody to make his own program and crosses. During that time, the training officer have to come. You couldn't see him. You just see somebody's way. It's coming. Would you like to drink water? He's not coming to give us water. He's following the training. Even he have to follow the training in the city. And before we leave from there, we have about maybe 2 hours or more than 2 hours with the training officer to tell us what is the weakest point, what is the strengthen, how we improve our skill. And also, this is in the case of breeding. Also, we have a chance to work in crop physiology with Dr. Tony Fisher at that time. And also, we did some activities. We have free times to do some activities. For me, I did some activities on kernel grass and the contribution of flag leaves to the yield by removing flag leaf or by decreasing the number of kernel number of spikes per spike to see what will happen to determine how much the grain the flag leaf contribute to the grain size or grain weight. It was very useful. Without this, we cannot learn, and I suggest this is a very, very good school, and by learning these techniques, we cannot forget it. And also, after we finish and we return it back to our countries, they have to follow us. There are several scientists came from CIMIT, and they came to my location to follow what I'm doing. Is I'm using what I learned there or not, and they have to report that. And I think CIMIT have the whole the file about from my training till maybe recently. I think this is, and I suggest that when the training is the most important component. If you develop a very good and germplasm and you send it to the national program, and if there is no candidate or no good staff to select, he will throw all the material out. But if you have a good trainers, good trainee, learn how to select the best material, he can make use of the germplasm, and he can make selection, he can do his own crossing program. But if the training have to have a special budget and continuous, not affecting by the deficit of budget allocated for the international centers, give priority to the training, and the training, the people who trained can make use, and this investment will be more efficient than to ignore training and spend more money on germplasm development or germplasm distribution. I think this is this is my idea.
If some young graduate from university would come to you asking, I have an opportunity to go for this course to CIMIT, why do you think I should go there? What it will give to me?
I think for the university, this course which I have is better, is good for the researcher working in the field. But for the university professor, he is just most of his time, this is an example, most of his time is teaching or...
But let's say a young graduate student, somebody who just graduated from university.
No, if he have a chance to go and to learn and to use what he was going to learn, it will be good. But if he went and learned and returned to other subject, or maybe somebody will be good to have this course, and when they return back, they work with some companies or other things or other department, is not related to this training, what is useless. Mm-hmm. This is a waste of time. The trainee have to come back and work in the field in the same institute, not to move to the other institute which have no relation to that subject.